Welcome to this edition of Backstage Pass with Lia Chang. Tonight, I am at ACT of Connecticut in Ridgefield, Connecticut, for the opening night production of Sunset Boulevard, starring Pearl Sun as Norma Desmond. She is making history as the first Asian American to play Norma Desmond in the United States. She stars opposite Michael Burrell as Joe Gillis, George Xavier as Max von Meyerling, and Helen Shen as Betty Schaefer. Ariel Estrada and I celebrated the opening night of Sunset Boulevard at ACT of Connecticut, and I had a chance to sit down with Pearl at her opening night party.
You know, Daniel C. Levine, our director and artistic director here at ACT of Connecticut, and his husband, Brian Perry, who's our music director. I have had the great fortune of working with both of them several times, and they're dear friends of mine, and they actually approached me to play this role, and it was never on my radar. I had never even dreamed of it, because I just could never imagine that this was an option for me as an Asian American female. And when they presented it, I said, can I take a moment with it and look at the material? And so I took a couple days to look at the score and kind of think on it. And I responded and called them back, and I said, look, it would be the most rewarding and challenging artistic experience, I think, of my career. And I welcome that challenge, so I would love it to work with you and do this.
I just graduated high school, and Glenn Close had done an out-of-town tryout in Los Angeles, and I got to see that. And it was with Glenn Close, Judy Kuhn, George Hearn, and I remembered, I don't remember the details of the production, but what I do remember is just being in awe of the grandeur, of the scope of it, the scale of it, of her performance in particular. And that really impacted me. And cut to 30 years later, here I am, and having this opportunity, and I'm really proud to be able to do this and hopefully inspire other Asian American actors to keep pursuing their dreams.
In the dark.
making.
This is actually a historical moment to have the two of us as Asian American females playing these two roles without any sort of question about it, any sort of having to validate it for whatever reason. And she's fantastic in her role. And I'm just so proud. Where it did impact me was offstage and backstage, and I'm going to get emotional. But, you know, she has only recently graduated from college, and just being able to support her in her journey and offer any sort of advice I might be able to offer to her, I welcome that opportunity, and she's become a sister to me. And to hear, because I'm in a quick change booth as she does her iconic duet, and just to hear her soar and to hear the response from the audience and them loving her, it just makes me so happy and so proud of her. Right. And so grateful that Dan and Brian had the capacity,
yes,
to say, I don't care what race, what they look like, the fact that they're both Asian and they're both the leading ladies in this thing, this piece, she's the best person for the part, so we're just going to do it.
Well, we can also take it a step further, because it turns out that George Xavier,
yes,
who was playing Max
von Meyerling,
is
fabulously, by the way,
Japanese, has Japanese ancestry.
Yes, he does.
So what is it like to lead this company as playing Norma Desmond?
This is the first in my career. I've covered leads in many shows, but I've never had to lead a company before. And this company has been a dream. You know, they've been so supportive every step of the way, and I need their support in this piece. All of my big moments, they're on stage with me.
Sure.
And they are fully engaged and fully listening and fully holding me up. And I couldn't have dreamed of a better company of people to help.
So can you tell me your three favorite iconic moments of the show?
Let me think. I mean, I guess with one look, that whole sequence, the whole opening sequence where she enters, she's dealing with the loss of a loved one, and then entering into with one look, and then going and putting up her offer to Joe Gillis to work with her and write with her. That whole sequence it's just the two of us. Max pops in here and there, but and it's very big. It's a long sequence. So that's one. I would also say, As If We Had Never Said Goodbye, which is meaningful to a lot of people. Mm. And then I think the finale. The finale with the breakdown and everything. And those are the three moments I think that I would grab from.
Thank you.
our set designer is incredible, David, and so he created this stained glass window.
It's astonishing.
With my face on
astonishing.
And then dozens of photographs, both on the wall and on our console and on small end tables of me in picture frames. But what it is photoshopped photographs with my face superimposed onto Anime Wong's iconic photographs. So it's her head, her hands, but my face on these photographs. And although it took me a really long time to get used to looking at my face on the walls and in these frames, I remind myself that this is for her. Yeah. And the limitations that were placed on her because she was Asian. And I think about that all the time. And the parallels that we made was that Norma Desmond also was at her peak and height at age 17. Mm. And that's when Anna May Wong was first discovered, was when she was 17, mm-hmm. when she had her big break. Mm-hmm. Although Anna May Wong was able to make the transition into talkies in a really good way, unlike Norma Desmond. But the parallel that Norma Desmond was kind of removed from the industry because she couldn't transition, right. and because she aged out of it, but that Anna May Wong could only reach a certain height because of her being
ethnicity.
Asian, because of her ethnicity. So yeah. that is the parallel that we drew.
Right.
And yeah. Well, first of all, it's a small house. It's 182 seats. I think that there is a real intimate quality to this version of Sunset that you're not going to get, that you hadn't got before, because the other version had, you know, obviously Broadway houses are 2,000 seats. So I feel like you can really connect with these characters mm-hmm. in ways that you couldn't before in
the past. I don't disagree at all.
Because you are really up close and personal with them, with us. And I really do think that this is a revisiting of an iconic piece, but really with a more human... I mean, I want to honor the past because it just is so iconic, but I feel like we bring a lot of heart... and humanity to these characters, or we try very, very hard to. And I know that it's a real, really special thing to have people of color in this piece that's been around for 30 years. I think it's really meaningful. Thank you for joining me for this edition of Backstage Pass with Lia Chang. Come see Sunset Boulevard at ACT of Connecticut. Performances are through November 19th.